It's October 30th, 2011. We're low tide, not a super low tide, but a low tide at the mill pond. And I'm just wondering what that piece of metal over there was. Sure would like to know. It's some kind of huge piece of metal. Robin Rogoff, October 30th, 2011. I'm on the North Concrete Pier of the Mill Pond, the City Boat Basin. I'm noticing some PVC piping, staking in the marsh, and I'm wondering what it is. It may be a survey plot for vegetation. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vertical PVC stakes. Or, I don't know, originally I thought maybe it was some kind of property boundary. We're standing just south of the Miss Kitty Ann that ran aground in Dennis. We're at a really low tidal stage now. This is Scipio Creek in Apalachicola, the mill pond. And this is after we don't know how much, many inches haven't been reported to us, how many inches came down, but we think at least 3 inches of rain in about a 12-hour period. It's October 16th. And we do have some water. The whole parking area here at the marina is underwater. So whenever they do build here, we've got a project slated. Stormwater management's got to be a big part of it. And this is the only part down here by the river that's got a lot of water on it. There's places all over town got a lot of, especially the alleys, got a lot of water on them, but this area is really bad. During tropical storms, we've had this whole area being inaccessible before. It is a high tide. I don't know if you can see down there at the ramp. It definitely is a high tide, but nonetheless, there'll probably be a lot of water standing on the ground here. And the seagulls and the boat-tailed grackles are enjoying it. They're having dinner. This is the ramp behind the harbor master's house where St. Vincent's is, office is now. Scipio Creek on October 18th, 2011. And just to show you how high the water is. It's way high! I'm going to step out on the dock. make my husband a little nervous. Go. The water is up. This is Robin Rickelvrogop, and I'm standing in front of the Department of Agriculture and Consumers Affairs building on the end of 7th Street in Apalachicola, Florida. It's January 31st, 2013, and I'm documenting the stormwater and erosion problems that are on this site. There's a parking lot. It's about 7,800 square feet. In front of the DACS building, they have created a berm of gravel to protect it from eroding. But what's happening is that instead of running down the hill here, it's running down on either side of their berm that runs the length of the parking lot. So if you can take a look at this situation here, this is the front of the old Ainer facility, which may become property of the city in the future. But the runoff problems are in front of me. There's a grade downhill there, here in front of me, and the water courses off of this parking lot. And you can see down this side here is a good example, but that's not the only wet place it courses. It also courses down the middle here, and you can see that over the years, it's created potholes in this asphalt paving here because of the amount of water that runs off this facility behind me, the DACS facility. So here's a close-up of where the water courses and what it's doing to the asphalt here. It continues, you can see down in here where it's actually washed a layer of leaves away and is running downhill here. You can see it's leaving a path of leaf debris on the asphalt and pushing the leaves away down here onto the asphalt. So it's coursing down here pretty strongly. And then this shows you the sand that's being pushed with this, and eventually, of course, the sand will become sediment that's washed into Scipio Creek Boat Basin. Here's more photographs of the sand that's being washed down on top of the asphalt here. We're walking across the parking lot in front of the modular. And you can see, I'm documenting again, you can see the sand that is washed downhill from in front of that facility, downhill into this area here, and accumulates on yet another berm that has been created with shell to try to slow the water coursing down this hill. Now, I'm going to walk towards the trailhead here, and this is where the worst problem is. This is the River Ramble Trail. It's been here since 1999,
and it's a Great Florida Wildlife and Birding Trail site. And you can see right down here that the worst problem, most of the water ends up down here, coursing down here onto the trailhead where it's eroded. It looks like in the past, it's eroded cement that's put in here. Recently, we regraded the oyster shells in here, and you can see that the water is washing down here so quickly that it is actually pushing oyster shelves, which are quite heavy, down the trail and creating potholes in the trail here. Okay, we're going to go back up the trail and we're going to go around the trailhead. There's some more of that sand that's being pushed down the hill. We're going to go around the trailhead and we're going to document some problems down here. Water control problems continue down here, and you can see where in the past someone has built an oyster shell berm right along here in front of this modular structure to try to divert the water, the stormwater that's coming off of this hill up here. Here's a washed area from last night. It's coming down here, and this is an old railroad tie berm that was done before the oyster shells, again to try to divert water around this structure, a modular structure. But despite those efforts, you can see down here where the water is pooling and it's actually pushing in on the skirting around that structure. This is Robin Vrokop. It's January 31st, and we're in front of the Department of Agriculture and Consumer Services Division of Aquaculture building at the end of 7th Street in Apalachicola. Now, in a previous segment, we took you down the trail downhill. We're documenting today the stormwater runoff problems, and we had maybe an inch of rain last night, not that much. Rained hard for about an hour and a half. And we documented some problems with the stormwater runoff going down towards Scipio Creek, which is dead ahead, about 100 yards dead ahead by as the crow flies behind that modular building, is Scipio Creek Basin. And in a prior segment, we were documenting the stormwater runoff problems down there. Now we're going to take you down the other side of this parking lot. This is all pervious paving right now. And you can see here again, it's probably about a foot high berm of gravel that's been placed along the edge of this parking lot in an attempt to divert water and keep their asphalt from washing away, like's occurred over in front of the Ainer building. So what's happening is the water is going to that side, or it's coming down this side. It's hitting that berm, and there's quite a bit of debris that's accumulated in front of it, and that's because it's washing from up here. It's going down there, hitting that berm. And rolling down here, and then down here in the corner, in order to keep this from washing out, it turns the corner and goes down here. All of this is in order to control the water that's coming off of that roof, which we're not sure what the size of that roof is, but I'm guessing it's probably about 3,000 or 4,000 square feet of roof right there. And there's no gutters on the property that I can see, not at least on the front of the property. So it washes right off that flat roof, hits the ground, and starts rolling. When it hits this pervious pavement, it just races downhill. So what happens to it when it hits this end of the berm they've created? It rolls down here. And you can see evidence right here where the water's coursed through here in the last 24 hours. Right here, because the leaves have washed up. There's the leaves have washed up. This is in the last 24 hours. This is from one rainfall, very moderate rainfall event. All of this is from the water running downhill here rapidly. So it runs downhill, and it looks almost like to me that this may be a wetland again. I mean, it is a wetland, but it's running right into this hole that was dug in the wetland less than 2 weeks ago. Here it goes. So we've dug a hole in the wetland, somebody has, and now there's water running in it, and eventually that is going to run into Scipio Creek, that stormwater. Actually, this is a perfect example, Mike, where you can see here, the light sand on top of the dark sand, that is the sediment that has washed from up there in this single event, because we've had no rain prior to when this hole was made about 2 weeks ago. So that you can actually follow the trace of that sediment that washed down the hill. It's laying on top. And in fact, if I go and take a stick or something, I don't have a stick. It's actually just its roots. But if I take my hand and dig, look what's underneath. It's dark. It's dark. All of this white light stuff is a sediment that has washed downhill in the single rain event last night. And I don't know how much rain we got, but we're going to look it up with the National Weather Service. This is a perfect example of sedimentation washing into a wetland. This was all black. I have documentation on camera of it. This is all black. And what's happened is the upland sand has washed down here in the single event. That's, in a nutshell, why we need to spend the money necessary to protect this wetland, protect Scipio Creek Basin, so that we don't have more damage. And all this doesn't end up in Scipio Creek Boat Basin. This was cleared. Remember, this was cleared. This road was cleared. And you've got all this is sediment washing from uphill. Okay, I'm continuing down down the trail, the River Ramble, and you can see evidence on all along on this shell path that the water has washed down here. This is the path the water has taken. And I'm not talking about a huge rainfall event. Moderate. Very moderate. Then when it gets down here, you can see the wash of the sand off to the side here. And it turns and it courses down here, and you can clearly see the path it takes towards Scipio Creek. So if there's any doubt where this water is ending up, this should answer it. It's ending up down in this wetland. So here it is, the path again. It's ending up down in this wetland, following right down here. Where it winds its way down into Scipio Creek. Here's another view of that water course coming from up there, which it originates at the DACS facility because that is the top of the hill, and comes down here all the way down to the marina, to this wetland here, which drains into the marina. This is the this shows the path of the stormwater runoff as it courses towards Scipio Creek Marina, because underneath this area is an impervious surface. It was once paved, and it's directing the stormwater right down to Scipio Creek Marina. This is Robin Broke Up, January 31st. 2013, and I'm documenting the location in this wetland down by the Scipio Creek Marina that is that the boardwalk and Great Florida Birding Trail traverses. This is a wetland that is down here, and what I'm documenting is the stormwater runoff now about 24 hours after the stormwater event. I mean, the rainfall event of last night, which was less than an inch or so of rain. It was a moderate rainfall. But here's the stormwater runoff. But I particularly want to draw the attention to the sediment runoff, the staining, the white staining in the vegetation here from either from the road, or perhaps it's from upstream. Don't know. We would have to follow it. It looks like it's from upstream to me, but it's the light sediment deposition on top of the leaves like this. There's the sediment, fine sediment that's running into the boat basin here. Not sure what the source is, but we can assume that it's probably upland of this. Here's some more of it here. Sedimentation. Sediment on the powdery sedimentation. And it seems to follow all in here. And here's the little berm that apparently is either built or accumulated to try to keep the water from running into that that wetland area. Once again, I'm standing where I stood just a couple of days ago after a half an inch rain. You can see that after today's rain, which is less than an inch, you can see all this area in here is definitely a wetland. And it's full of water. I believe our Apalachicola developmental code for this area calls for no development within 60 feet of the wetland areas. In this zoning code, which is research conservation, we need to be setting a good example down here, not what this is. And you can see a plume of sediment coming out right down here underneath, across from that drain. The drain is right across there, and there's a sediment plume. I hope this comes out on the camera, but you can see a very clear sediment plume coming out from that drain pipe that starts out there. This is the outfall. Starts over there. Comes across. It's about an 8 or 10 inch in diameter pipe and goes under the road. And you can watch. As the tide goes out, it's pulling the sediment with it. See the sediment cloud? This is February 7th, 2013. This is a perfect example of what happens with sediment. It's seeping out. It's actually probably seeping through the ground somewhat in here too, the water. But there's a fallout pipe right down here. Right down in here. Now, I can't see it because the tidal stage is so high, but it's right down in here. And it's just... It's February 12th, 2013. I'm just taping a flagging that says wetlands delineation at Scipio Creek Marina. There's several others along here. A flag right there. Got wax myrtle. That looks like mulberry there, but a big wax myrtle right here. And the other thing I wanted to film was this little wetland that's draining here. Frogs leaping in there. Doesn't smell too good. Lots of particulate in this. Let me see if I can get a better picture of the particulate. Come on, you guys. It's frog mating season. Here's the particulate. I don't know if it's going to come out. There's so much reflection. Mm.
all this. This may be the wrong time to film this. This is the pipe that's running under the road that circles the Scipio Creek Boat Basin. It's February 12, 2013, and this is low tide in the north side of Scipio Creek Boat Basin. And you can see the drainage pipe now exposed there. Also see a lot of sheen on the water in here. Thank you.